216-391-9500.
Hello, I'm Peg Neeson with WVIZ PBS Idea Stream, and you are in for a treat because coming up is a fabulous concert that you will be seeing for the first time here in Northeastern Ohio. But more than that, it's the star of the show. Standing right next to me, Dennis DeYoung, who will be in Cleveland actually soon. Welcome to Cleveland, we should say first. Thank you. He's waving to all of his fans.
Thank you so very much.
And Dennis, you're coming to Cleveland.
I am. I can hardly wait. It's going to be a concert extraordinaire. Doesn't that sound good?
It does sound good.
I want to clear up one thing before we start the show.
All right.
Where's the camera? I am not Tony Bennett's kid. Thank you very much.
But you
because
got,
right away they're going like this, hey, Marge, come look, Tony Bennett's kid's on PBS.
Okay, but let me tell them an important thing is that you've been extraordinarily generous to WVIZ because you believe in public television and everything that we do, that you've given us a bunch of tickets. And if you call in and pledge tonight at the $250 level, they'll get a pair of tickets to your concert, which is going to be at the State Theater on March 6th, 8 p.m., but these just aren't any tickets.
Let me just say something. $250 for a pair of tickets?
Yeah.
Outrageous. The Eagles tickets are $300 a piece, for goodness sake. This is a bargain. How could you pass this up? And you get to see who?
Well, you.
Oh, well, there's the catch. I knew there was a catch to this thing.
I'm sorry.
Apparently that's it. Oh, that must, if that's my wife, tell her I'm not here.
But actually his wife is here. But
my wife is here.
I do want to seriously tell you that if you call in and pledge, and you pledge at the $250 level using a credit card, you will get the best seats in the house because the tickets aren't even on sale yet. You've reserved the best ones for WVIZ.
These tickets are exclusive right now tonight to the people who pledge for PBS because it is such a wonderful cause.
It is. And we're so glad you're here, and we're going to go to the first act of your concert. You're going to love it. Call us at the next intermission and show your support of WVIZ.
Welcome to the future. PBS Digital.
Major funding for Soundstage is provided by Allstate.
Let's say this is you. Yeah, you're the king. But being the king isn't always easy. With Allstate, you'll have over 50,000 professionals to help protect you. From claims adjusters who can help you fix a broken castle, to emergency assistants to ride your rescue, to lawyers that go to court with you if you need them, and your Allstate agent who knows the moves to help you. Helping the king feel protected. Just one more way you're in good hands with Allstate.
This program was made possible by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
someone else's fantasy. So if you think your life is complete confusion, 'cause you never win the game, just remember that, well, it's a grand illusion. Deep inside, we're all the same. We're all the same. I'm smiling. Give me, oh, oh, all your love. Your hands build me up when I'm sinking. Just touch me and my troubles all fade. Moment
I saw you standing, oh, 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 alone. You gave all the love that I needed. She's so shy, like a child who had no.
Tonight's the night we'll make history. Honey, you and I. And I'll take any risk to tie back the hands of time and stay with you here. The worst of times, and I do believe it's true. When people lock their doors, they hide inside, and rumor has it end of paradise. But I know if the world turned upside down, baby, I know you'd always be around my life.
The best of time,
yeah.
Oh, when I'm alone with you, some red sunshine will make this a world for two.
Our memories of yesterday will last a lifetime. We'll take the best, forget the rest, and someday we'll find.
These are the best of times. These are the best of
red. These are the worst of times, and I do believe it's true. I feel so helpless, like a boat against the tide. How I wish the summer wind could bring back paradise. But I know if the world turned so my friends will say goodnight, for time has claimed its prime. But tonight can always last as long as we keep alive the memories.
the star of the show.
Thank you. Thank you, Cleveland.
Turn this way.
Oh,
this way, this way, this way.
Oh, I thought Cleveland was over there.
Well, a lot of our favorite people in Cleveland are right here, our volunteers who are in through the evening. And if you recognize him from the tape, here he is right here in the WVIZ PBS studios. Dennis DeYoung, we're so delighted to have you here.
Boy, I'm as pleased as punch to be in Cleveland, really. It's a great city, and the chance to be on public television right here, it's just a thrill.
Oh, that's great. You know, Dennis, you have made a very generous offer to us, and we want all of you to take advantage of it. If you call in and pledge at the $250 level, you will receive a pair of tickets to your concert, which is happening at the State Theater.
It is?
It is. I'll tell you all about
when
it.
When is that?
That would be March 8th at 8 o'clock. March 6th. Forget, you tell me about it.
If the people come March 6th and they really like it, I'll stay to the 8th.
Okay, good.
I don't care.
Hey, but you know what? The important thing is that these tickets have not gone on sale yet to the public, so you are guaranteed the best seats in the house. We're the ones that are down front. So, folks, give us a call and pledge your support. Dennis, tell us about your background.
Well, I was born and raised in the city of Chicago. I still live there. I was in Styx from the very beginning. I founded the band. Oh, geez, really, it's the nucleus of the band were the Panazza brothers and myself, and that goes back to almost 1963.
You were two?
I was 14 years old.
Yeah.
And then the band stayed together throughout college, and James Young joined in 70, John Surleski in 1970, and then Tommy Shaw in 1975, and then we became Styx in 1972, recorded our first album in 1972. And we had a wonderful career for, I don't know, up until I think about 3 or 4 years ago, I was in the band. And since that time, I've left and gone on my own and done these wonderful orchestra shows.
This is a fabulous, I mean, that orchestra, besides your own band that you have, but hearing your music with an orchestra that huge, it must have been just a thrill.
Now, let me tell you a story. There's a guy sitting off camera. His name is Tim Orchard. I'd like to say this was my idea, but essentially, I was sitting in my house one day. The phone rings, and it's Tim Orchard, who is a promoter and a producer in Chicago, called me up and said, "Dennis, this is Tim." I said, "Yes, Tim." He said, "I have this idea. Dennis DeYoung and the music of Styx with a 50-piece symphony orchestra." I said, "Tim, how much Valium are you taking these days?" I'm thinking, me and a symphony orchestra?
But isn't it the coolest? I mean, to hear the music with the symphony behind
Here's what
you.
He said to me. I said, "You know, Tim, it costs a lot of money to write the orchestrations."
Right.
I said, I don't believe in myself enough for that.
Yeah?
He said, "You go put the show together."
Yeah.
"I'll take care of everything else." So what we did was, I was like a kid in a candy store. I just went and said, "What if we took a, like in that first segment, we have Lady."
Yeah.
That song Lady was written for my wife, Suzanne, the first song I wrote for her back in 72. And I was a music teacher at the time, and junior high school music teacher, and I was a music appreciation teacher. And I said, "What if we took a bolero and put it in a rock song?" So we put a bolero right into Lady. And now, some years later, 30 years later, I said, "What if we actually stopped the rock song and put Ravel's bolero right in the middle
of it?" Oh, don't give away the concert.
No, they saw it.
Oh, that was already in the first segment?
That just happened.
Well, remember, you'll see a lot of this if you call in and pledge right now at the $250 level when Dennis comes with the Cleveland Pops Orchestra here to Cleveland on March 6th. And we're going to go up and talk to Jeannie Zeller right now.
I can hardly wait.
I can't either.
Up to you, Jeannie.
We need to get a phone ringing right now with your pledge at the other end of it. We've got a couple of people on the phones were reserving their tickets. Remember, these tickets haven't even gone on sale yet, so you are guaranteed the absolute best seats in the house. And the first people on the phone are going to be sitting way down in front in those seats that when you go to a concert, you say, what do you have to do to get to sit down there? You're going to be sitting down there right in front. If you're lucky, Dennis will spit on you. Pick up the telephone right now and reserve your tickets at that $250 level. I'm just looking at this song list, you know? I'm old and I'm feeble and the mind forgets things, but when you see this list of songs, The Best of Times, Lorelei, Too Much Time on My Hands, Fooling Yourself, Come Sail Away, Mr. Roboto, it goes on and on and on. This is the music of your life, and this is going to be a once-in-a-lifetime experience at the State Theater on March the 6th. That's a Saturday night, a weekend. You can make a great weekend of it. There is Suzanne, that's Dennis's wife, welcoming a new member right now. It's going to be an experience with a Boston Pops Orchestra and Dennis DeYoung performing. Fabulous. You're just getting a sampling of it in this concert. He's so excited about performing for you. So join right now at that $250 level and get those front row seats reserved for you. Let's check in with my good friend Tom Myros.
Hey, thank you, Jeannie. Boy, the phones all of a sudden have taken off. We are very excited tonight to have Dennis DeYoung in our studios. And he's here promoting not only his upcoming concert on March the 6th, which we have tickets for, but he's also here supporting public television. That's what he has said to us. He said, I'm here not only to talk about me, but he says, I'm here to help your television station become that much stronger because we're able to show this programming to you. This program was made possible because a member several months ago made a donation, made a pledge of support to continue the type of unique programming that you've come to expect here in WVIZ PBS. And I'll tell you, being the home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, it certainly doesn't hurt to get some of these great rock groups coming through here and supporting public television stations because they understand the importance of it. And they also realize that they reach a unique audience that they want to reach as well. You're part of that group that they want to talk to, and we want to talk to you. You can do that by calling 1-800-473-2525. And if you call now, if you would rather not do deal with tickets, we have some ways that we can say thank you. If you want to make a pledge at $120, we can send you a DVD of the show that you're watching right now, uninterrupted. And you know, with DVDs, you have all those little extras that you can get in those, little extra side things. It's going to be more television that you've seen now. And it's not available in stores. It's only available here by calling 1-800-473-2525. Also, if you'd rather, at the $90 level, we have the two CD set of all the great music that you'll be listening to as you watch this program. The people, you're going to hear things like Babe, Show Me the Way, Mr. Roboto. And I'm sure that brings back a lot of memories for so many people. That's coming your way at the $90 level. You know what? If you've got $300, it's only an extra $50 more than the tickets. Here's what you get. You get the tickets to the show on March the 6th. You get the two CD sets that I just described. And you get the DVD of the concert. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you can't beat this with a big stick. The only way you're going to get it, though, is to call Big Sticks. Big Sticks. It was a pun that I intended to make there, Dennis. Oh, it's going to be one of those nights here at WVIZ PBS. You know what? That's what makes it so much fun, that he's here. He's helping you raise funds for your public television station. Peg, over to you.
Hey, Dennis, every phone is off the hook. I think people want to call in and get tickets.
Mayor Campbell, are you kidding me? I didn't know you were a Styx fan. Get out. You're kidding me. Mr. Roboto. Unbelievable. Listen, we'll see you at the show. Mr. Roboto, who knew that?
I've lost it.
Unbelievable.
I've lost it. Hey, Dennis, so.
You know, Mr. Roboto was originally written from my hairdresser, Mr. Roberto? No, it wasn't. No, it wasn't, Mark. Go ahead,
Peg. Wasn't really?
I'm sorry.
I'm like believing
all this stuff.
I'm very gullible,
absolutely,
so you have to be.
Absolutely.
So, Dan, tell me, because you told me before that you actually brought this concert to public television for a reason.
The truth of the matter is, when my daughter, who's now 32 years old, Carrie Ann, you'll see her later on in the program. She comes on stage during Come Sail Away, cute little blonde girl. I put my arm around her.
Okay.
When she was a kid, every afternoon, because I was a musician, I had a lot of free time on my hands.
Right.
Apparently, I had no employment.
So no, you just work nights.
We'd watch Mr. Rogers, Sesame Street, Zoom, and the Electric Company all in a row. And I mean, it was just it was the greatest time for us to sit there. And I was just at QED in Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
And the castle, Mr. Rogers' castle, is right there in the lobby.
Yep.
And you know, I was looking for Meow Meow Kitty.
Yeah. Well, now, did you see her eyes just light up as she's watching these shows and learning and growing with that?
And you know, the fun part about it was is that in watching those shows, I learned the alphabet. I could count to 10. Listen, Abkadeki Jekamanaka Stewart says.
Very good, very good.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes, very good.
And how about this? And one more.
Okay.
We're going to zoom, 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 a zoom.
He knows his public television.
I love public television.
And you know, you told me another great story, which was this is a soundstage special.
Yes, it is.
And you were, tell me that story.
Okay. The original soundstage program began in 1972 in Chicago.
Yeah.
It was originally called Made in Chicago. The pilot was done by none other than Styx, who was a brand new band, and we did the very first show. Made in Chicago then became the soundstage series of the early middle of the 70s. And then come full circle when they did this soundstage, which just began last year, I did this show, which was the pilot for this one. So that was really terrific to be involved in both of them.
That's fabulous. What a history. And you can be part of this history, too, if you call in and pledge your support right now. Remember, for $300, you're going to get a pair of tickets to the concert at the State Theater. You're going to get the You Cannot Buy in Store DVD. Mm. You're going to get the You Cannot Buy in Store CD.
Right.
And you're going to be supporting public broadcasting. So call us right now, pledge your support, do it right now. You know, all the phones were off the hook a minute ago, Dennis, so we got to get them ringing again.
Come on, let's go. Cleveland rocks.
Let's go up to Jeannie.
Well, right here, here's a couple in the front row. Here's a couple in the front row in front of you if you don't get on the phone soon. Here's a couple in the front row, and there's another one there. They're in the front row. What about you? This is going to be a terrific evening, a historic evening. You haven't heard Styx music in a long time, and Dennis is going to run the gamut. He's going to sing all your favorites along with a full orchestra, with the Boston Pops Orchestra at the State Theater. And you are going to want to be there. People are going to talk about it. At the $250 level, you will be truly in the best seats in the house, because these tickets haven't even gone on sale yet. They are available to you tonight on this station only if you will go to your telephone and make that pledge of support, because Dennis, as you heard, is a big fan of public broadcasting and wants to support public broadcasting. We get support in all kinds of shapes and sizes. We want to say thank you to the Renaissance Hotel, which I hope is treating Dennis in great style. I'm sure they are. They always do. And we want to say thank you also to American Limousine Service, who is taking Dennis and Suzanne all around our lovely city. So thank you very much for your support. But now it's your turn. You know, there was a time when just about every time you turned on to public television, you heard big band music, because the people who were pledging and supporting the station wanted to hear big band music. Well, this is the music of your life, and if this is what you want to hear, then get on the phone and get your tickets. Get in the front row. Over to Tom.
Okay, now the phones have calmed down just a little bit, so what you might want to do is, if you've been thinking about it, jump in now, get those tickets so that you're not looking in front of somebody else's head. You're the front row, you're in the second row, and you've got excellent seats. Remember, these are exclusive to us. We're announcing the concert tonight here on WVIZ PBS. It's on March the 6th. It's for $250. You get a pair of the best seats of the house that they have at the State Theater. And again, we're doing this with the Cleveland Pops Orchestra. So imagine these great musical numbers from Dennis DeYoung behind the Cleveland Pops Orchestra at the State Theater on March the 6th, 2004. Mark it down now. You know what? You can get that by calling 1-800-473-2525. Don't wait. Do it now. You know what? If you would like to support us at the $120 level, we have some ways that we can say thank you with some exclusive offers that, again, are courtesy of this concert that you're watching on television right now. The Dennis DeYoung in concert, the soundstage for a show that you're watching right now, uninterrupted, will come your way. It's exclusive to us right now. You can't get it anywhere else but here on WVIZ PBS. Or perhaps you'd rather support us at the $90 level. We can say thank you by sending you the 2-CD set. And again, this is only available by making your pledge to WVIZ PBS now. It is exclusive to us now, so don't wait. And you know what? For another $50, here's what you get. If you'd want to go see the show, for $300, here's a package that you can't really say no to. You're going to get the 2-CD set. You're going to get the DVD of the concert. You're going to get the 2 tickets to the show, and it's a terrific night out, and you'll have the best seats in the house. So we're going to send it over to Peg. You take a look at that $300 package, and you know what? It's worth every single penny, plus the great programming that you get here at WVIZ PBS. Peg.
Thank you, and I am so delighted to introduce everyone to Carl Topolo, who's the conductor of the Cleveland Pops.
Not the Boston Pops.
Not the Boston Pops. The Cleveland Pops. Everyone, let's welcome Carl. Now, Carl, your orchestra will be playing with Dennis and his band that travels for this great concert. But you guys have a wonderful tradition in Cleveland and play all year long.
We do. We play New Year's Eve. We have a concert series at Severance Hall.
Well, New Year's Eve is like a tradition now,
isn't it? Indeed. It is. And we play at Playhouse Square and various places around Northeast Ohio.
You've become an institution.
Thank you. We're really excited about this opportunity to play for Dennis. He's terrific, and I think it'll be very special. special evening for us.
It will be. And you know, you and I have something in common.
What's that?
Besides loving great music. And that is, we both watched, in separate houses, mind you, but
right.
We both watched the recent production of Oklahoma on
WVIZ. Just great.
Tell me about your reaction to that.
I was bowled over. You know, I'm used to Gordon McRae and Shirley Jones, and it's in the last scene where Judd sort of conveniently dies. But you know, that's a real fight that they had on stage.
I thought it was incredible.
And then when they interview the actors, you hear the British accents, and then they become Oklahomans.
Wasn't that amazing?
It was really quite astounding.
It was amazing.
Is my microphone on right?
I just want to say one thing.
Yes.
The cowman and the farmer should be friends.
They should. They should.
That was from Oklahoma. Yeah, right. Dennis watched it too. We all have something in common. So now tell me too, you must have young ones at home.
We do. I've watched Clifford every morning, or Arthur. 8 o'clock.
Oh, Arthur. Yeah, Arthur.
Arthur's and Caliu, Sagwa.
Oh, you know the whole schedule.
I know them all.
Gosh.
When you have a 7-year-old, that's what happens.
Yeah, that's true. So we've got the New Year's Eve concert coming up.
Right.
And then is there something before March that happens?
Yeah, we have a February concert with the Valentine's Day program.
Perfect.
In March, the Broadway Baritones. April, Byron Stripling, a great New Orleans trumpet player. And on our fourth annual Armed Forces concert in May, which is always a sellout.
Oh, that'll be great. Well, thank you so much for being
here
and showing your
support. Oh, thank you. It's my great pleasure. You bet.
And we're going to go up to Jeannie right now. Jeannie?
We need to get these phones ringing again. Look at these two beautiful people who are just waiting to talk to you. Remember what the deal is. Dennis is going to be performing for the first time with the Cleveland Pops Orchestra at the State Theater. And you know, if you've been to the State Theater, it's a great house. There isn't a bad seat in the place, but we've got the best seats because they haven't even gone on sale, and you're available to you tonight. The concert's at March 6th at 8 o'clock. It's a Saturday night, so you can sleep in the next day, and you will be listening to full orchestra along with Dennis DeYoung. That's at the $250 level. If you'd like to pledge at the $120 level, we have a DVD that is not available in stores. You can only get it by dialing that number at the bottom of your screen right now and becoming a member of WVIZ PBS. If you'd like to pledge at the $90 level, we can send you the music that you're listening to in this concert this evening on compact disc. But why not go for the $300 level and get the whole shebang, the whole enchilada. We'll send you the DVD, we'll send you the CD, and we'll give you the best seats in the house to see Dennis DeYoung and the Cleveland Pops Orchestra perform at the State Theater. You cannot beat that. You really, truly can't. If you've got somebody special in your life, there's Valentine's Day and all of these holidays coming up, why not give this gift right now and be a hero? If you love Styx music and you love Dennis DeYoung, this is your opportunity. Don't let it pass by. Enough of my ugly mug. Let's go back to Dennis.
You don't have an ugly mug, Jeannie.
Let's go back to Dennis anyway.
That's right. So, Dennis.
I mean, whose show is this?
Well, it's yours. It's yours. So,
tell me
about what's coming up in the next segment of the show.
I wrote a musical based on Victor Hugo's The Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Yep.
And this segment features just two songs from that musical. It was fully staged in Nashville, Tennessee. In fact, Magic Productions, right here in Cleveland, was one of the producers.
Oh, no kidding.
Hey, Lee, out there? Anyway. So we're going to hear Mike Eldred, who's a guest vocalist who played the role of Quasimodo in the original musical. He's going to sing a song called Ave Maria in a duet with
me. That's a gorgeous song. I heard
it.
It's beautiful. And you wrote this.
I wrote this. All this music.
Is all the music in the show your?
Yes.
Okay.
Absolutely. I wrote the whole musical and parts of the book. Not the Victor Hugo book, but the stage book.
Right.
And there's another song called With Every Heartbeat that features Dawn Marie Fusey, she's the female singer, Mike Eldred, and myself.
Well, it sounds wonderful. I know it is wonderful because I watched it already. I got a sneak preview of the whole thing. So we're going to go to that. You can still call in the numbers on your screen, get those tickets March 6th here in Cleveland. Dennis, fabulous Cleveland Pops Orchestra, and your band, you're going to love it. Call.
Why not?
Become the public in public television by becoming a supporting member of WVIZ PBS. Please have your Visa, Discover, MasterCard, or check debit card ready and call the numbers on your screen with your pledge of financial support. Or send your gift of $120, $90, or $60 to Membership, WVIZ PBS, 4300 Brook Park Road, Cleveland, Ohio, 44134. Or become a member online at www.wviz.org. Thank you.
Was I born into this world of hatred and scorn? No one could see the sorrow and shame hiding in me. What peace that I knew. Were these moments with you? But today someone touched me so sweetly, my soul came alive. And though I fear she never will see the man I know I could be, please let me dream. Ave Maria, pray for me in my moment of need. What can I do? Never before have I been untrue. I've given my life. No family or friends, no children, no wife. I've asked no reward. Just the work of our Lord. Where can I go? With every breath I feel for my soul, you know I've tried to keep my passions locked up inside and never give in to temptation or sin. But the powers of Satan can be stronger than any man's faith. In a world corrupt and depraved, give strength so that I may be saved. I beg of you. Ave Maria, pray for me in my moment of need. Ave Maria, how I hope. Ave Maria, pray for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, with every heartbeat.
Since heaven sent you here to me, I have only loved you so. So afraid to show you how I feel. Can this love be real? And after all that I've been through, understand that I would die. Would never part. With every heartbeat I'll dream of you. With every breath, every sigh, hoping someday
down.
Mike Eldred, Don Murray.
I gotta tell you, that is a beautiful score and wonderful lyrics. And it's beautiful. It's absolutely gorgeous. And you still have those pipes going there, too.
How about that other guy?
Well, the other guy.
Eldred, that guy could sing, too.
Wow.
You know, people ask me, you're going to ask me how I can still do this at my age?
Sure.
Oh, what is that? Here's the secret.
What is the secret?
No drugs, no drinking,
yeah.
No smoking,
yeah.
and I buy thong underwear, two sizes too small.
And it's especially
two sizes,
that last thing.
Two sizes too small?
Yeah,
one is not enough.
Now remember, folks, Dennis will be here in Cleveland on March 6th, and for a $250 pledge, you can have the best seats in the house because they haven't even gone on sale to the public. So you want to get in on this because we have a limited number of these tickets, so you want to do this quickly and get involved with WVIZ and become a member. I'm intrigued by your switch from pop music into musical theater because it's not only Hunchback, but you had some runs otherwhere.
Cleveland has a very warm spot in my heart because I made my acting debut in this town in Jesus Christ Superstar as Pontius Pilate in 1993 with Carl Anderson and Ted Neely and Irene Cara, right here in this town. I think it was the State Theater. Could it have been there?
Could have been the State or the Palace or the Ohio, yes. Or the Allen, one of our Playhouse Square theaters.
I played Pontius Pilate for 6 months in that production. We did it in New York and all around the country, and bring me the head of Moses. Well, that's the wrong show, isn't it? That's Ten Commandments.
Yeah, but it's close. It's yes. Close. So this is pretty. Are you going to do more?
What happened was is because as an actor, I did the 8 shows a week, and I had some time off during the tour. I said, you know, I would rather write these musicals than actually stand on the stage and be in them. I've had a lot of offers to act again since, but I really. To me, the joy is the creative process of writing the music. That's the greatest joy for
me.
And
how do you go about doing that? I mean, do you just sit down at the piano and start noodling around, or do you say, gee, I think The Hunchback of Notre Dame is a really cool story. I'm going to write a musical about that.
I always say this. I have a piano in my back room that's got a whole bunch of good songs in it. I just have to sit there long enough and hit the keys long enough until they fall out. I wish it was simple, but I don't know.
So now what we need to do is go up to Jeannie and get these phones ringing, because what happens is you and I talk.
We
and
talk,
they
everyone listen. I'm not going to talk again until the phones ring.
Okay, Jeannie.
Okay, let's get them started. We can start right here in this row, and let's take it all the way down, and you can help in a big way. It's the holiday season, it's the season of giving. You're buying gifts for everybody and their brother, you're buying gifts for people you don't even like. Why not give yourself a gift tonight? You've worked hard all year. You deserve it. Wouldn't you like to be sitting right down in those front rows watching Dennis DeYoung with the Cleveland Pops Orchestra in March, all cozy and warm inside, listening to extraordinary music? And Peg is so right. Dennis's voice sounds better today than it ever did. He's just wonderful, so very talented, and we're so thrilled that he's here in the studio. And one of the reasons, the biggest reasons that he's here, is because he loves public broadcasting. He told us right from the start that this is where he wanted his program to be, on public TV, because he's a public TV viewer and a supporter. And to give you an example of his commitment to public television, he's doing 13 stations. We're the third station on his tour. He's going around to 13 different stations in 14 days, on and off those planes, into public broadcasting stations, and he will be doing concerts in each of those cities. We're fortunate to be among those 13, and we hope tonight you'll take advantage of those wonderful tickets. Remember, they're at the $250 level. You will get best seats in the house, but you know what? For another $50, why not go for the whole shebang? If you join us at the $300 level, you'll not only get best seats, a pair of best seats, we'll reserve them for you right now before anybody sits down with big hair or a hat in front of you. And you'll also get the DVD of the program you're watching and the CD. the music of the program you're watching. Neither one of them are available in stores. Actually, it's a two CD set. You cannot go to a store and buy those. They are only available here on public broadcasting because Dennis cares so very much about public TV. So pick up the phone right now and give us a call, won't you? Reserve your tickets as we go over to Tom.
Thank you, Jeannie. You know, WVIZ PBS is your window on the world, and we bring you a variety of programs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And that's made possible because someone like you made a pledge of support to your public television station. They did it several months ago, which made it possible for us to go out and purchase the type of programming that you've come to expect here at WVIZ. We can't do it alone. We get some of the funding from government sources, which is shrinking. We get funding from foundations, which helps. The biggest support that we have is member-supported public television. You make up the biggest chunk of the donation that we get in, the pledges that we get in, and we need your help now so we can continue to go out and get the type of programming you've come to expect. Now, tonight we've got a very special program. We've got Dennis DeYoung in our studios. He's talking about a concert that's coming here on March the 6th. This is being announced tonight for the first time on your public television station. No one else has a chance at these tickets, or no one else has a chance at these DVDs or the CDs. They're all available to you, but this concert is for you, and you get first crack at it. You're going to be in the first 15 to 20 rows of the State Theater. They're going to be beautiful tickets, up as close as we can get you before anybody else has a chance to get them. That's for $250. But you know what? If you would rather make a pledge of support at maybe $120, we can say thank you by sending you the DVD of the show that you're watching. And again, this is exclusive. It's not available on Amazon. It's not available at Borders. It's only available on your public television station. So act now. That's at $120. We'll send you the DVD of the concert that you've been watching and are watching right now. Then we've got the $90 double CD set that we can say thank you by sending the great music uninterrupted. And again, that's all available by calling your public television station. And that number is 1-800-473-2525. So get up out of the chair, make that call now. Let's get the phones busy because right now they are totally silent. Peg, over to you.
Thanks, Tom. I'm here with Carl Topolo from the Cleveland Pops Orchestra once again. And you're here because the orchestra is going to accompany Dennis at the concert.
That's
in
correct,
March.
Peg.
That sounds like a fun departure from what you usually do.
Well, it is. But when our orchestra comes to play, they come to play Pops music. So whether it's Rodgers and Hammerstein, you know, Broadway, movies, light classics, jazz, or Dennis DeYoung, they're ready to play pop music.
Now, here's a little quiz I got for you.
Okay.
Okay. When people come to see the Cleveland Pops, do you let them in for free?
No.
They have to buy a ticket?
Yeah.
Well, you know what? Here on public television, they get to watch for free. But then we ask you to call in and make a pledge. Just like your friends and neighbors who have called in the past and made that pledge, your ticket costs pay your expenses. Our members pay our expenses.
Right. When I heard Oklahoma last week, I picked up that phone and I
made
called.
The call?
$90 and
well,
CDs on the
much.
Way.
You yeah, bet. That's very good. Now tell me, when you guys get together to do a concert,
right.
Is it a quick turnaround? How does that happen?
Yeah, basically we have a rehearsal in the afternoon, rather extensive, and Arnie Roth, who is Dennis's arranger and conductor, will be doing that. And I have complete faith, having watched him on TV now, I know he's going to do a great job. And then we perform that evening.
But you aren't even in town for this.
No,
you're
actually,
gonna
I'm
miss
not,
it.
Unfortunately. I'm conducting out of town. But the orchestra's in good hands.
Well, good.
I'm not worried at all.
Well,
and Dennis will be great.
He will be great. And we want you to give us a call right now and pledge your support to WVIZ PBS. We're going back up top to Jeannie.
I want to do a quick thank you to American Limousine, who very graciously agreed to show Dennis and his lovely wife around our wonderful city, and also to the Cleveland Renaissance Hotel at Tower City. Great friends of WVIZ PBS for providing places for our guests to rest their heads. And now I want to say thank you to you because you went to the phone and you became a member. Go to your telephone right now. Remember, we've got those tickets available for you. Best seats in the house. Talk about beating the box office. These tickets aren't even printed yet, so you've got an unbelievable opportunity here right now to reserve best seats in the house for Dennis DeYoung with the Cleveland Pops Orchestra at the State Theater on March the 6th. take someone you love and relive some wonderful memories with the music of Styx and some of Dennis's original music you haven't heard before. It's going to be an amazing evening, and you're going to be so glad that you made that pledge this evening. Pick up the phone right now and give us a call. Let's go back to Dennis and Peg.
Well, we've had two great acts already, or segments. I don't know exactly how you want to break
act is good.
Act is good?
I like it.
What's coming up next?
There's going to be all my greatest hits in this next segment. White Christmas, Stairway to Heaven, Hey Jude, all those songs.
I didn't ever associate those.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Dennis.
We're going to have Mr. Roboto.
Okay.
Don't Let It In.
Oh.
Babe and Come Sail Away and Lorelei. All the big
rocking
and rolling and jumping on Madonna and some ballads. It's what a thing this is.
And well, another thing will be that on March 6th, Dennis will be here in Cleveland with the Cleveland Pops Orchestra at the State Theater. You can have tickets. You can have great tickets, but you can't have them if you don't call. So call the number you see on your screen, and we'll be back to talk to you after the next great act.
Become the public in public television by becoming a supporting member of WVIZ PBS. Please have your Visa, Discover, MasterCard, or check debit card ready and call the numbers on your screen with your pledge of financial support. Or send your gift of $120, $90, or $60 to Membership, WVIZ PBS, 4300 Brook Park Road, Cleveland, Ohio, 44134. Or become a member online at www.wviz.org. Thank you.
Got to plain to see. Too much technology, machines to save our lives, machines to humanize.
For a short time during World War II, my dad's platoon was stationed in Holland in the home of a Dutch family. Their eldest son was a concert pianist, and every night he would play for the GIs. This next song was one of the songs he played, and it was my dad's favorite piece of classical music, featuring Rick Snyder.